Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Mike. Now, when Einstein talked about his formula, he talked about the objective energy. He talked about subjective energy, like we are talking about subjective energy. Now, what is an objective and a subjective one? An objective one can be perceived with the biological senses and sometimes with the aid of extensions such as the telescope and microscope and so on. And subjective means something that cannot be detected or measured objectively with the biological senses or its extensions. So Einstein is talking about objective energy. Talks about energy times mass, or equals mass times the constant of velocity, speed of light, c squared. That's what he means about matter. Well, we're talking about energy, subjective energy, not objective energy, that has to do equal with to mind times controls squared. And mind is a subjective something because it cannot be seen or measured. But then mind functions in a subjective dimension, whether we can measure it or not. We know it has parameters. How much can we think in one direction or the other? What has been our goals? What goals have we reached and so on? So we're changing the formula to represent our field, not Einstein's field. Subjective energy, where we are dealing with mind and its power of mind multiplied or squared. So two different types of cells. One cell we call cells are going to develop brains to produce the objective concept, which means objective matter, subjective, that they exist in two different dimensions. An animal exists in the objective and subjective. Plants exist in the objective and subjective. What is the objective? Everything about the plant that can be seen with objective biological senses. What's subjective? The part of matter at its depth that cannot be perceived with biological senses. Inanimate matter has it. Animal matter has the objective and subjective. The human brain has objective, subjective, left brain hemisphere, and objective, subjective, the right one, plus the spiritual components. Now, the spiritual component is what distinguishes the animal or the human being from a common animal. We are in charge of the planet. We are the highest level of intelligence, life intelligence on this planet. There's nothing higher than us, so-called humans. If we function as we're supposed to, as humans, not animal-like. And now we know that a human is not one who looks like one, he's one who acts like one. There are many who appear to be humans and they're beasts. They don't care what they destroy. They're not human. They're not fully developed human beings. Something is missing. And what's missing is a spiritual factor that happens to be in the right brain hemisphere, not the left one. And can you imagine why we are going in all wrong directions now? Because we have found that 90% of humanity is using only the left brain hemisphere that does not contain the spiritual factor. And the spiritual factor is what humanizes a person. Now you wonder why we are in this field, trying to straighten out that problem, to see if we have enough time now to educate as many human beings as fast as we can to prevent the destruction of the whole planet because of ignorance. Not knowing that we are the gods of the planet, and those that think they are do not know how to use the powers that God has given them to act as gods. They use it for destructive purposes instead of constructive purposes. Now we know why we're in trouble, but now it's your job as much as it is mine to see if we can straighten this out. Because I believe that the planet, the way it's going, is not going to go too far from now on into the future at the rate it's going. Because we're not improving. So we need to be more serious about this work and to put more time into it to see if we get all the people to understand what's going on and get them back on track. They're going out of their own grooves, you know. We need to get them back into the groove, the original model again. A lot of distortion has taken place. We need to go back to the original again. Then it will function like real, fully developed human beings. Can you imagine the world where mind is really functioning as God has intended it? We functioning as gods, there would never be crime, nobody would ever attempt to hurt anybody, anything. Wars would be obsolete because mind will know who's trying to do something and prevent the surprise factor. Be ready for them in case anybody started something or wanted to or planned to. The world of the mind. We think that's the goal of the human being on this planet. To convert this planet into a paradise by using mind, fully developed mind, correctly. So now you are invited to participate in such a project. Each one of you is responsible, mind you, responsible to at least, see, two more people happens to become aware of this need and become interested in participating. Each one of you are responsible to see the two more people join these principles, these ideas. Okay? So then we'll be materializing, or we'll say reaching our goal that we started to way back. We said our most popular formula is 1 plus 2 equals 5 billion. If every one of us, we see two more people become interested in this field, we have no time at all. We have the 5 billion plus that are on this planet going in the same direction. So now, not only are you invited, but I think you're responsible now. You can get out of it now, because now you know what we're supposed to be doing. There's no way to say that, well, I didn't know about it. Now we do know.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.